Hey guys, as many of you know, I went from being a single dude to dating a lot to finding that perfect one, and now we have a daughter, Farina. She has her own YouTube channel, so almost 20,000 subscribers there. That's kind of interesting. The YouTube channel is actually doing better than this. So these are the 15 least attractive hobbies to women. So let's take a look if we recognize any specific hobbies, okay? So the least attractive male hobbies, percentage responded attracted by activity. Comic books, 33.6%. Cosplay, so not women cosplaying, but guys cosplaying, 32.1%. Debating, 30.5%. Drinking, 29%. And MTG, 28.5%. So after that is anime, makeup, crypto. Crypto is out here. Clubbing, marijuana. Funko figures is 12.3%. Arguing online is tied with Funko figures as a hobby. Corn, which is 10.8%. Gambling, 6.4%. And the Manosphere, or Andrew Tate, right? These are, if, and you look at the other hobbies, they're like 97%, 98%. Magic the Gathering is in the bottom 10. It's actually at number 11. The 11th least attractive hobby to women. Now, again, I'm going to, you know, I've dated a lot recently. So when I graduated law school, I was engaged, broke up. My ex-fiance, she is actually married now as well. So no kids, but you know, I was the first one to have kids, so that's good. We still are good friends. So it's hard, man, playing Magic. And there's another graph here about Magic the Gathering. It's not good. MTG is not good. The Manosphere, arcade games, politics, D&D. Antiquing, boxing, MMA, watching TV. I mean, these are all hobbies that if you tell a female, she is going to run the other way. So I dated probably 10 or 12 different women for about the span of two and a half years. I did have some benefits. I am a multimillionaire and I own my home, which is the government is trying to say my home is worth $600,000. I protested, and now they say my home is worth $570,000. So that means whatever. $570,000. I drive a really nice sports Lexus, which I paid in cash. I have massive anime. But the anime stuff didn't really match. So here's what I can tell you about dating, because I had dated a lot recently, and now I have a daughter. I found the right one for me. There's no one going to be perfect. They really hate Magic the Gathering. They're okay with Pokemon. In fact, my current relationship is with somebody who is really into Pokemon. She loves Pokemon. We play Pokemon Go. We used to travel to New York City, Las Vegas to play Pokemon Go. Pokemon's okay. You won't see Pokemon on this thing, okay? You're not going to see Pokemon, but you will see MTG, and you are going to see Manosphere. You know, 2% people find that attractive. Which is, you know, it's pretty bad because you look at the other stuff. Playing an instrument, how many people find that attractive? 95%. Okay, that's a lot different from Magic the Gathering. Cosplay, how many people find that attractive? 32%. Now, how many males find cosplay attractive for females? Probably much, much higher. Guys, you cannot tell that person. I know you go, oh, I'm going to find one for me. No, no, the percentages are against you. The percentages are mutter effing against you. I'm going to unattractiveness, drinking, video games, watching TV, marijuana, arguing online, corn, gambling, Manosphere. Like, I'm here to tell you that this stuff is not going to work. The reason that Friday Night Magic is on Friday is because they assume that you don't have a significant other. When I was started dating online, and I would text them. It's like, oh, okay, cool. What do you want to do? Do you want to get lunch on Monday? Do you want to get coffee? Sometimes they would do like a coffee but and then I had to like travel. I work from home now into the city, so it's not the best. But they always want to do Friday dinner in the city or somewhere nice. Nobody gonna be saying like, "Hey man, why don't we do play Friday night Magic?" No woman will ever say that. I'm here to tell you guys what the truth is about this, and you guys don't want to hear it because many of you are single males. A lot of you guys are going to end up alone the rest of your life. You are going to end up alone the rest of your life. You will. There is no other scenario for many Magic players. And you can tell because they're older. There used to be this butt crack guy, and then he went to the Richmond tournament. It was all dudes with butt cracks. Like, you tell me what a woman would think if she walked into something like that. Many of the women in the comments, because it was a huge news, it was on BuzzFeed and a lot of other places on Facebook. A lot of the women thought that was a plumber's convention, an all-male, homosexual plumber's convention. That's what they concluded. I'm not joking. That's what the comments concluded it was. They didn't think it was a Magic the Gathering. They didn't think, there was a card game. They literally thought it was a plumber's convention. All the women voted on it and they on a BuzzFeed article, and that was it. So, you know, as someone who has recently, you know, got into a relationship, now we got a young daughter, I can understand why this is the way it is. It's really, really obvious to me now, on hindsight, that, like, Fridays are for dinner dates, Fridays are for travel, Fridays are for stuff. Weekends are, you know, like, women do not want to play Magic. That is the last thing they want to do. Right, they want to travel, they want to, you know, they don't want to collect stuff, they want the experience of going to different places, and it's expensive. It's more expensive than Magic the Gathering. Like, let me just be quite honest with you. Yeah, it's more expensive than Magic the Gathering because you spend that money traveling. When we went to Las Vegas to see Lady Gaga, the tickets alone for Lady Gaga, just the tickets, not the plane ticket, nothing else, right? $500 a pop to see money effing Lady Gaga. I mean, I like Lady Gaga, but holy shit, $500, like, a ticket. And they weren't even, like, the greatest seats, man. I mean, they were okay. And then we had to see this other singer in Austin, and it was, like, another $400 a ticket. And, man, I mean, they ain't no dual lands, I tell you that much, man.